Hi everyone, this is Indra. Welcome back to my channel. Today in this video I am going to discuss about one very important application of derivative, that is calculation of the interval in which the function increasing or decreasing. We can use the derivative for the calculation of the interval in which the function is either increasing or decreasing or remains same, neither decreasing nor increasing. Please watch this video till the end so that you will get the concept of increasing and the decreasing interval of a function, as well as some basic ideas of the derivative of a function. And if you don't subscribe my channel yet, please make sure to subscribe it and press the bell icon for instant notification of the uploaded videos. Without wasting any further time, let's get started. Here, to illustrate today's topic, application of the derivative for finding the increasing and the decreasing interval of a function, I have taken a question related with this topic. Here the question is, find the interval in which the function f of x is given here. It is defined x cube minus 6x square plus 9x plus 15. Is increasing or decreasing, also find the stationary point. Here the new term stationary comes here. Let's solve this question. Here the function is given f of x. It is given here. Let's suppose this is y. It is y. It is given here x cube minus 6x square plus 9x plus 15. This is the given function. We have to find out the interval in which this function increasing or decreasing. For the calculation of the interval of the increasing and the decreasing of a function, we have to first find out the first derivative, that is dy over dx. Let's calculate, let's differentiate this equation with respect to x. Let's differentiating with respect to x. Let's differentiate this function with respect to x. Then our left hand side will be dy over dx. This is derivative of y with respect to x. This is, let's do the differentiation on the right hand side. Here the 3x square, this is by the power law of the derivative. 3 will come in the front, 3 and 1 decrease in the power. 3x square minus 6 times 2 gives 2 when x plus this 9, and the derivative of constant is always 0. Here we have calculated the dy over dx is this quadratic equation, and let's factorize this quadratic equations, and this can be further factorized. Let's take 3 as a common, and after taking 3 as a common, our expression will be x square minus 4x plus 3. Let's factorize this this expression inside the parenthesis, and here the if we multiply the numbers, if we multiply the numbers, then the product will be 3, and if we add, then the result will be 4, and that numbers are simply 1 and 3. So the factors will be x minus 1 and x minus 3. If we add 1 and 3, then 4. If we multiply 1 and 3, then 3. Here we just factorize this quadratic expression into the two parts. These are the factors of this expression. This is just dy over dx. Here we have calculated the dy over dx is 3 times x minus 1 times x minus 3. And please remember one very point for increasing conditions of a function. The function is said to be the increasing function. Please remember this very important point. A function f of x is said to be increasing function if dy over dx is just greater than 0. For increasing function, let me write something about the increasing condition. For increasing function, or for increasing condition, the dy over dx, it is the first derivative, should be positive, greater than 0. Let's plug in the values of dy over dx from this expression. 3 times x minus 1 times x minus 3. The result of this inequality should be positive. Let's solve this inequality to get the solution set for x. For the increasing functions, we are going to evaluate the interval for the increasing function. And let's calculate. We can divide this inequality both sides by 3. After dividing, our expressions will be x minus 1 times x minus 3, just greater than 0. Here we just divide by 3 on the both side. And for this number, for the product of the two numbers, for the product of the two numbers to be positive, either these two should be positive, or these two should be negative. They should have the same sign for the result or the product to be positive. So they should have the same sign. Conditions will be, first conditions will be either, first condition is either they these both are positive. Let's take x minus 1 greater than positive, greater than 0, and x minus 3. Please remember very important point, for the product of the two numbers positive, they should have the same sign. Either they are both are positive or they are negative. Let's simplify this inequality first. Here let's simplify this two inequality. This is just x greater than 1 and this is just x greater than 3. And the common part for these two inequality, let's find out the common part. The very easy way is by plotting on the number line. Let's make the number line. This is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on to infinite. This is the value of the x. Here negative 1, negative 2, and 2 negative infinite. Here the x, let's take the first inequality, x greater than 1. 1 is here not included, x greater than 1. X greater than 1. 1 is not included, so open circle, x greater than 1 from infinity. This is for x greater than 1. This line is for x greater than, here 1 is not included, here not included, so open circle. And the let's plot on the second inequality also. Here the x greater than 3, this means where is the 3 is not included, here 3 is not included, so open circle, x. This is for x greater than 3. X greater than 3. And the common part to both the inequalities, common part is just x greater than 3. Common part is this region. This shaded region is the common part. And the inequality form, we can say x greater than 3. So the common part, this result. The result of this both the condition, these both conditions is just x greater than 3. Here we got the intersection of these two solution set as a x greater than 3. And this is the first condition. And the second condition is for the product to be positive, they may be both negative. Here we take both positive. And let's turn off the both negative. Negative means here the x minus 1 is less than 0. And x minus 3 also less than 0. If these both are less than 0 or both are negative, then the product will be positive. Let's simplify this. This is just x less than 1. And x less than 3. Let's calculate the common region for these both inequality. Here the x less than 1. Let's make the another number line again. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on to infinite. Here negative 1, negative 2, negative infinite. Let's plot first x less than 1. X less than 1. Here the 1 is not included. And the left hand side. This is the number line representation for x less than 1. Here 1 is not included, open circle. And then let's plot the x less than 3. X less than 3. X 3 is not also included. X less than 3. This is the normal line representation for x less than 3. And the common region for these both the inequality is this. This is the common part. So the result of these two solution sets is just x less than 3. Here from the first solution set, from first we have here we have got the x greater than 3, and from the second conditions we have got x less than 3. And for the positive, either these conditions or these conditions here. So we have to take the union of the these two sets. Either these conditions holds true or this condition holds true for the positive result. So let's take the union of this solution set. X greater than 3 union is the one set, and the union of the another set x less than 3. We have to take the union in the OR case. Here is the OR case. So either or, in either OR case we have to take the union of the sets. And its union is x less than 3. X less than 3 means negative infinite to 3. Negative infinite to 3. Negative infinite to 3 union x greater than 3 means from between 3 to infinite. Here here we just calculate the union of these both inequalities. X less than 3 means between negative infinity to 3, so union. And the x greater than 3 means between 3 and infinity. This is the required solution set. This is the required solution set for the function to be increasing. This is the required interval. This is the required interval. This is the required interval for increasing condition. This is the condition for increasing. Here we have calculated interval for the increasing conditions. Let's calculate the interval for the decreasing conditions. Let's calculate decreasing condition. Please remember very important point. For the decreasing of a function, the first derivative dy over dx should be less than 0. Please remember this very important. Let's plug in the values. For this, if we substitute this value of dy over dx, then the expression will be x minus 1 times x minus 3 will be less than 0. Let's solve these conditions. For the product of the two numbers to be negative, they should have the opposite sign. This is valid either x minus 1, let's take it is positive, either this first one is positive and the second one is negative. They should have the opposite sign. Let's solve this. It is just x greater than 1 and this is just x less than 1. And if we simplify, if we solve this both the inequality, the common part will be x greater than 1 and x less than 3. This will be the between 1 and 3. This is the solution set for common to both the inequality 1, 3. This is the interval. Or the product will be negative if the first is negative, if the first is negative and the second is positive. X minus 3 is positive. Here in this first case we have take the first as a positive, here we take the first as a negative, and second as a, here we take the second as a negative, here we take second as a positive. This should have the opposite sign for the product to be negative. Let's simplify this. This is x less than 1 and this is x greater than 3. For these two inequality, there will be the no common part. X less than 1, x greater than 3. There is the no common part for these two sets. So they, because they are the disjoint sets, so the intersection will be the empty set. And let's evaluate the union here, the either or condition. So we have to take the union of these both conditions, and the union of one from between 1 and 3 and the another set 5, the union is just this set 1 to infinity between 1 and 3. So the this is the required, which is the required, it is the required interval. This is the required interval for the decreasing of a function, for the decreasing condition. This is the required interval. And here we have calculated first here the increasing conditions. This is the increasing condition. This is the interval for the increasing conditions. And here in this paper we have calculated the decreasing interval. And the question is not only this increasing and decreasing, it is also about the stationary point. Let's talk about the stationary point here. Stationary points. It is also called as the critical point. Please remember this term, critical point. It is also called as the turning point at which the nature of the function, either it is increasing or decreasing, will be occurred here. After the stationary point, the functions either will be increasing or decreasing. For the stationary point, the condition is just dy over dx equals to 0. Please remember this very important point. And here we have calculated dy over dx as a this expression. Let's plug in the values of dy over dx. It is just 3 times x minus 1 times x minus 3 is 0. Let's solve this integral. This is valid when the x is either 1 or 3. This is valid when the x is 1 or 3. If the x is exactly 1 or 3, then the stationary point or the critical conditions will be occurred here. Critical point means at which the functions will neither increasing nor decreasing. This is the point. So the point, required point for the critical point is just the value of the x either 1 or 3. Here we solve this particular question by using the concept of the derivative. It is all about the increasing and the decreasing nature of a function as well as the stationary points. In our next video, we will discuss more about the application of the derivative. Please keep watching, keep loving this channel. This much for today. Thank you.